Welcome into the Dynasty Total Access. It's your boy Expert. You know I got the homie Farquaad with me. What's up, my dude?
What's up, my guy, man? Getting closer to playoff time. Let's get it, man.
It's getting crunch time, and that's the business we got to talk about to start the show. When you are in crunch time in the Dynasty, why would you play the computer? You got to take the force win. I understand dudes got pride, want to get the win on their own merit, but guys, to get into the Dynasty playoffs is a difficult thing to do. Just ask around. We got dudes begging to get into these final 12 spots. You know we love the OG Chris Murray, but you got to take a force win when you get a chance. Come on, Farquaad.
Hey, let's that is a major head scratcher for him to go, you know, it's crunch time. You're fighting for, I can understand if you were a division leader or, you know, or one of the top guys in the conference, had the number one, number two seed, and you can afford to play the CPU, but you're fighting for the second spot in the wild card, you know, the AFC wild card spot. The first spot, the first spot is pretty much taken by the homie HB and the Titans. They pretty much have the first wild card spot taken over. But with Chris Murray and the Raiders, hey, you're fighting for that. I'm right behind you. You got the Ravens coming too. I need you to lose some games. So, and looking at the record and looking at your schedule, and looking at my schedule and the Ravens schedule, we're coming for you, bro, for that second wild card spot. I'm glad you got that loss. But that was questionable. I would have picked the fourth one for sure.
Yeah, we'll see if that comes back and bites Chris Murray in the end. But let's get into the Week 14 Dynasty picks.
We got
a couple new nicknames. We'll go through those as we get to those games. But first up was the Cardinals and the Colts, and I think they playing right now.
Yeah.
I know both you and I would have picked SJ and the Cardinals, so we'll just move on. Next up, it's the rematch of the rookies. It's Houdini and those Ravens going up against HBO and the Steelers, who's got a new nickname. Shout out to the homie H-Speed. He gave the homie Steelers a new nickname. He's now called Drag Route Shorty.
Drag Route Shorty.
Man. And this one's an easy pick for me. I'm picking Houdini and the Ravens. Easy win against the Steelers.
We got our guys listen to Total Access. I appreciate everyone that listens to us and take what we say and take heed to what we say.
No doubt.
So with that being said, HBO, I know you're gonna listen to this show, bro. I need you to win this game. This is the game I need you to play spoiler. The Ravens are on a roll. He's fighting. He is also in that three-man race for this wild card, the second wild card spot. HBO, I need you to win this game. All the Ravens do is throw the football. That's literally all he does is throw the football.
Yeah.
All he does. So with that being said, bro, all you have to do is defend the pass. Defend the pass, and the game is yours. Play smart offensive football. Steelers, HBO, get this win, bruh. And keep your cable on for another week. HBO to win.
You got to stop throwing the ball down the field, though, with that quarterback, HBO.
Yes, man. Play smart football, guys.
57 rating. He just can't throw the ball deep. But shout out to the homie Houdini, playing very well at the end of the year, trying to get into the playoffs. Very impressed. Been very quiet, staying in his lane, winning football games.
That's all we ask you to do.
Yep. Now we gotta get him on the show somewhere, because I'd love to hear his opinion on some things. Maybe we can get some love-hate going with the Ravens.
You always hey, the doors open.
No doubt. Next up, it's the OG C-Rob with those Panthers going into Philadelphia to play John, the Donut Man, and those Philadelphia Eagles. The Eagles not making the playoffs. The Panthers still fighting. I'm picking the Panthers to beat the Eagles this week because the Panthers will be focused trying to get into the Dynasty playoffs. Panthers with the win.
Oh, yeah. Philly, he's just looking like he's starting to string together a few wins. I always say home field advantage is major in Madden, man. Home field advantage is everything. It seems like Madden seems to give you the benefit of the doubt if you're the home team. But I love the way C-Rob plays, clock management 101, and he I see Carolina going into Philly and getting them a win and trying to fight for the NFC wildcard spot, no doubt.
No doubt. Next up, it's expert in those Cowboys going to New Orleans to play Tazzarelli and the Saints. Now, when I looked at this game, this is a trap game for the Cowboys because I got some very difficult games coming up after this. And I'm fighting with the Giants to win the NFC East. I appreciate Hot Tub beating the Giants, put me back in first place, but I gotta win some games to stay there. And I'm gonna start against Tazzarelli. I'm picking the Cowboys to beat the Saints.
I'm going with my buddy, man. Tazzarelli, Dallas got some momentum. Tazzarelli, I don't think it's gonna happen this week, bro. Don't think it's gonna happen this week, man. Experts gonna stay in first place with the win.
Appreciate that. Next up, it's my co-host. He's got to play those pesky Dolphins. It's Mo Booker going into Buffalo to play Farquaad and his Bills. Now, Mo Booker not making the playoffs. Farquaad fighting tooth and nail to maybe win the division or maybe even snatch that second wild card. We'll see what happens. But I know the homie wants to make the playoffs this year. So we're going to get a very focused Farquaad. I'm picking the Bills to beat Mo Booker.
Shout out Mo Booker, man. It's always a battle, but you have not beaten me at all this Madden, and it's going to continue that way. I got to get this division. I got to get this wild card spot. I got to get it. So I got to stay afloat. I'm coming hard and heavy this round, man. I'm taking a win this week, man. No doubt.
No doubt. Bills with the win. Next up, it's Hamiltop and the Vikings going up against the Commish, Nasty Noob, and those Atlanta Falcons. Now, Deion coming off a pretty embarrassing loss, but there were some shenanigans in that game.
See?
We'll talk about one of those shenanigans when we get to that player's game. But I've watched Deion's players just take two steps and freeze like they was playing freeze tag from when we was little kids. Linebacker ran through the hole, would have had a sack, probably would have been a fumble. His strong safety just never even moved, just standing in cement, just some crazy things. We're gonna try and address those that in a new show. I said it. There is a new show coming to the Dynasty Network.
Let's get it.
Cannot wait till that show happens. That show is going to be on fire every time we do that one. I can't wait. But the homie Nasty Noob is upset this week. He'll never admit it because he's going to be even killed because that's the type of commish he is.
Mm-hmm.
But I know he is pissed off and he's going to take it out on Hamiltop and those Vikings. I'm picking the Falcons with the win this week.
Now, before I make my pick this game, I want to say, it seems like with any game, I'm just gonna give a little preview for a preview into the show. Just my take on something here. A lot of these games, these franchises like Madden and Call of Duty and all these other games, they seem to get all the patches and stuff, you know, knocked out, you know, first couple months, and then when it reaches the year mark, and then they get closer to the next release, the game pretty much at that point falls apart.
It's
a lot of things happening, a lot of things just not going on. And the way our format is for high stakes, like everything matters going into the final season. At the same time, a lot of things are going wrong with the game. So me, my personal take, maybe we should get together and try to change the format as far as when high stakes will be, and maybe take some of these Super Bowl winners into contention as far as I'd pretty much just change the format on how to pick teams, because I'd be pissed. I got far too much at stake going into the next Madden for the game to have all these technical difficulties happen, and it's fucking me in the end. So maybe we should rethink the formula as far as choosing teams for this next Madden, because it's crazy how this game's falling apart now, you know? But that's just my take. With that being said, Deion, he's coming into this game pissed off. Atlanta with the win this week, bro.
No doubt. Next up, his two very good users, his King Vitamin and those Browns, going up against Andy Force and the Jaguars. Now, I don't know what happened to the Cleveland Browns last week.
Ugh, yikes.
Maybe it was darkness just got tired of taking L's.
Yikes.
And finally showed up. I don't know. I don't ever hear from darkness. I couldn't tell you.
Very true.
But I promise you this. The Browns, he's not taking two in a row. So I'm picking King Vitamin to come out, get back on top, and beat the Jaguars.
This is going to be a good game. I'm going to be tuned into Jaguars escaping a very narrow, narrow win last week against my Bills. Hot tub. The Browns coming off a very, very bad loss.
Just ugly.
Cincinnati. Very bad loss. This is going to be a battle. In the end, I think hometown cooking is going to come into effect. And
wow.
Miami Andy Forrest with the win this week, bro.
Wow. Can't be upset about that pick, especially after the way the Browns played last week.
Yeah.
Next up, let's talk about those Cincinnati Bengals in darkness.
Okay.
Going up against the homie Matty Ice and the Packers. Now, we kind of roasted darkness a little bit on Total Access last week. Called him out, wondering what's going on. Is he tanking? Is he dedicated? All of those things. And he came out and he put a beat down on King Vitamin. It looked like the old Bengals to me. But that just furthermore proves to me that maybe something's not right in Cincinnati.
Okay.
Because for you to go 0-11 and then come out, I'm sorry, 0-12, and then come out and put a beat down on one of the guys I consider a top three user in this league. And you've played some cupcakes on your schedule. Just looks a little funny to me. That's just experts' opinion. I know I'm not the only one thinking that. But as far as this game goes, I'm not picking against my homie Matty Ice. I'm gonna ride with that dude for a while. He got some things going on in Green Bay. Wait till he add a couple more pieces. He gonna battle for that division. I'm picking the Packers to beat the Bengals.
Man, I said this last week and the week before. There was some rumbling coming out of Cincinnati that we had some tank game going on. And going into the game last week against Hot Tub, or after the Hot Tub game, I was like, yo, he played a very good game against Hot Tub. If he would have turned down on them, you know, them turnovers, cut down them turnovers, he could have blown out Hot Tub, to be honest. I thought
right.
He played a very good game. So with that being said, I still don't know what's going on there. I hope he's not. I don't think he's tanking. But hey, he put the beat down on Vitamin.
And almost put the beat down on
Hot Tub.
Yeah.
So this week, I'm going with Cincy with the win, bro. Hey, prove me wrong. Don't tell me you're tanking, bro. Get this win, man. The homie Darkness with the win this week.
Darkness with the win. Next up is Skill Trade and those Chiefs. Still haven't heard from Skill Trade. Man, pop in the chat every once in a while. Let us know that you're alive. But this week, he's going to get killed because he's got to play Hot Tub in the Broncos. And there's no way Hot Tub is taking a loss versus the Chiefs. I'm picking the Broncos. Easy win.
Look, at this point, Kamish.
No doubt. Speak on it.
You guys listening, I'm not going to beat a dead horse.
It's time. It's
time. Get the man out of here.
It's time, dude.
That's the first one. Go get him out of here.
It's time, man.
You know, if you listen to this Skill Trade, I would love
he's not Farquaad. He's not.
I'm just saying,
he's not
to pop up and say something, you know, respond, but
yeah,
that's not the case. Get him out of here. Get him out of here. Period.
He's not watching the show.
Yeah,
he's not liking the show. He's not hitting the retweet on no tweets. He's not doing none of that stuff. I think it's just time.
And it's basic. Get him out of here. That's number one, man. Give him the boot.
It's time to move on. Well, we let's get off of that because we both picked the Broncos.
Yeah, Hot Tub with the big win this week.
Big win. Because next up, we got the Dynasty Game of the Week.
Who you with? Who you with? Get Grump. Who you with? Who you with? Who you with? Who you with? Get Grump. Who you with? Who you with? Who you with? Who you with?
Let's get it.
It's KP and those Lions going up against Addy 5 and the Bears.
Oh, yeah.
I can't tell you how big this game is. The winner of this game has the inside track to the NFC North. Mm-hmm. It's basically their division. And the Bears beat the Lions last time. So you know KP is coming out, and he's going to try and get some revenge for that L he's got on his schedule.
And he beat him in Detroit, bro. He beat him in Detroit.
He beat him in Detroit. Right, yeah. This one is in Chicago.
Yeah.
But here's the thing. I just think Addy 5's got KP's number. And Addy 5 is playing well. So you know I got to pick my boy. I'm picking Addy 5 and the Bears. Going 2-0 versus the Lions this year.
Hey, you know what? I'm looking at the Daddy League. I'm looking at the Daddy League matchup. This game is close up and down right now, man. And all the, they've got Daddy League estimated score. They've got the Lions winning this 24-22. Okay.
Wow, close.
I mean, even Daddy League knows how close this game is going to be. Both of these teams are pretty much spitting mirror image with each other when it comes to their gameplay. I feel like it's going to come down to defense. This is going to be a defensive battle right here. I'm going to say final score maybe 13-17, 13-10. I'm giving it to Chicago. Chicago's going to get this game. The home cooking is going to come into effect. And he wants to take first place in that division, man.
Oh, so you know it.
I'm giving this to the homie Addy as well. Sorry, KP, but I'm gonna be watching this game right here. This is one of the best games of the year right here. I'm ready for this.
No doubt.
Addy with the win this week.
These are the kind of games we need to get organized and call these games live.
Yeah.
Commentary.
Well, I'm about it, man.
H-Speed. Farquaad and I are calling it. We need to start doing some live broadcasts for some of these heavy-hitting games right here. Man, speaking of heavy-hitting games, we got another one right after that. It's the OG Chris Murray.
Yeah.
Those Raiders going up against Z Spiro and the Giants. This is the battle of wide receivers if you've ever seen one.
Mm-hmm.
Chris Murray took a loss against the computer where if he'd have played the user versus the Eagles, he would have won. Should have took the force win, in my opinion. I know that's how Farquaad feels. Mm-hmm. Should have took the force win. And he's playing a very dangerous Giants team who's in a tie for first place in the NFC East. So you know I gotta go with the homie. I gotta go with Chris Murray. Just like my homie Farquaad always says, Chris, if you listening to this show, I want you to turn the volume up. Listen, the Giants likes to throw the ball deep. Okay? He also likes to run that crossing route across all the way across the middle and hit you right at the sideline. So you got to play a good cover four, cover six against him, but you got to get those DBs back because his wide receiver will run past you. But you can't forget he likes to run a little sneak up the middle with his running back. He also likes to run a little outside run. Just a little scouting 101. I need this win, Chris Murray. I'm picking the Raiders.
We on opposite sides of this. Hey, Spiro came off a nasty loss against Hot Tub last week.
Yeah,
I thought it was going to be a high-scoring game. But 31-7 was not a high-scoring game.
No.
Good God. I don't know what happened. But, Spiro, if you are listening, I need you to get this win, bro. Right now, that second wild card spot belongs to Oakland. Myself, I'm right behind him. Well, actually, it's the Ravens, and then I'm behind the Ravens. I'm going to get my win this week. I need you to do your part. And, yo, we need to string up some losses for the Raiders. So, Spiro, get that win this week, bro. I need you to win this game, man. Giants with the big win this week.
Yeah, can't be mad about that. Next up, two users going in the wrong direction. It's underrated, and those Redskins going up against Mr. Friendzone himself and those San Diego Chargers, a.k.a. Breezy.
Mm-hmm.
Now, underrated lost his quarterback last week versus the Cowboys. Broken collarbone. Jeez. Done for the year. Wasn't playing very good anyway. And I like what Underrated said in the chat. He's got a wide receiver, Dotson, that if you look at his attributes, should be a top wide receiver. but just drop some balls that just kind of make you scratch your head. Now, as the Cowboy user, I'm not too upset about it, but I can understand the homie's frustration when he's a high 80, low 90 catch, and he's dropping some of the easiest routes in the world. Maybe that's something we need to talk to Madden about. I know they tried to tweak that early in the year, but I just don't think they've completely fixed it.
Mm-mm.
And he gets a San Diego team that just took a left turn somewhere and ran away from the season. I don't know what happened to him. But with underrated losing his quarterback, I gotta go with Breezy and the Chargers in this one. It's gonna be close, but I'm picking the Chargers to beat the Redskins.
This is a coin toss game. But I think underrated can win this game. And I say that because he has defensive personnel to make it happen. It's up to the user from there. I'm looking at San Diego stats, man. The reason he took a major left turn because he relied too much on the pass with the rookie quarterback that's not groomed, and his biggest target and one of his slowest targets, DeMarco Acronaw, he's got 48 receptions. He's doubled. The next closest is 27. 27 receptions.
Yeah.
He's spamming that big time receiver. He's nice, but he's slow.
He is slow.
And he's forcing a lot of passes. And that offensive line. I mean, bro, he's got that quarterback's taking 42 sacks.
It's
and
crazy.
He's thrown 56 interceptions this year with a 46.7 QB rating, bro.
What was that? How many interceptions he's thrown?
56 interceptions he has thrown, bro. 56.
They're not selling him Madden 18. They not
run the football, man. Run the football. Switch up those linemen. Run the football. Do something, man.
Yeah, dude. You gotta do something.
With that, man, I feel like if Redskins play smart football, just play some solid turnover-free football, and you got this game in the bag, man. Because that offensive line ain't shit in San Diego. You got this in the bag, man. Redskins with the win this week.
Yeah, it's going in the wrong direction in both of those teams.
56 picks, though. 56.
56 interceptions,
God,
dude.
Damn.
Man. At some point, you're not allowed to throw the football.
Hell no.
At some point.
Killing that rookie QB.
Maybe
killing
not.
That rookie QB.
Next up, one of our favorite users. It's HB30 and those Tennessee Titans. And he gets the big homie and the Patriots this week. Here is our second new nickname of the Dynasty. Big homie, you have now been rebranded as the Check Down Shorty.
Check down shoddy.
Dude like throws to the running back or the fullback 40 times in a game.
I'm not tired with that dude, man.
It's just so frustrating. It is frustrating. But we'll let that go because you're fixing to catch a beatdown this week. Titans with a big win.
Oh, yeah. I'm not wasting time on this pick, man. HB finna run that football down his throat. Big win for the Titans, man.
Okay. Next up. This is a big game in the Dynasty. It's that boy Good and those Jets going into Tampa Bay to play Gil Garza and the
Let's
Buccaneers.
Let's go, Garza! Let's go!
Now, if this was Butters' sim game, the last Mohican,
automatic loss.
Stretch Armstrong, I'm automatically picking the Buccaneers. We're not wasting time on this. But because it says that boy Good above the Jets, you got to kind of think about this game because you know that boy Good got some skills.
I ain't thinking about shit.
I know you not because that's a division rival. But this is what I'm going to say. We know it's almost playoff time in the Dynasty. Gil Garza's not playing around.
Nah.
Shout out to Gil Garza getting win in the tournament the other day.
Most def, bro.
Appreciate you repping Dynasty. Now, I know he's got some work to do with that defense. Gil Garza, just reach out to your boy expert. I'll let you know all about the Cowboys defense, where their strengths and weaknesses are. I can help you out. But you know Gil Garza repped the Dynasty real well.
Good shit, bro.
No doubt. And this week, I'm picking him to beat the Jets. No disrespect to that boy Good, but I just think Gil Garza is on a different level during playoff time. Bucks with the win.
So, the homie Garza And again, big shout out to you for representing the league, getting that win in the tourney, man. Good stuff, bro. That was a dog fight. That was one hell of a dog fight you pulled out there. I need you to get this win this week, bro. I don't care about that boy. I don't care. I need you to get this win. You've got I need your help. So mano de mano, I need your help, bro. Because I've got the Dolphins and the Saints next. Those are two wins. Sorry, Tazzarelli. Both brothers. I got back-to-back brothers this week. Now I'm knocking them both out. If you win this game this week, Garza, I'll be one game behind. Okay? And then the Jets turn around and plays. After next week, the Jets turn around and plays the Dolphins, which is going to be an automatic win.
Easy win for him.
And then I've got your brother, and I'll beat him. Now, the week after that, you got the Jets. He's got the Broncos. He's got Hot Tub.
He's got Hot Tub.
With that loss, bro, we would be tied for first in the division. Going into the very last week where I play you, bro. I play you. God, I play you week 17. And the Jets.
Rest your starters.
Bro, and the Jets plays the Patriots. So, once again, going into the final week, it's going to be a battle. Again.
Madden be screwing Farquaad at the end every single year.
So, Garza, get this win this week, homie. I need you to... I've got faith in you. I feel like you'll handle the Jets with ease. Get this win this week, bro. So I can build my late season momentum and just pray to God Madden favors me somewhere. Pray to God they favor me.
Bucks
with the win this week.
Hadn't worked out the past two seasons.
Oh, I got to get out of Buffalo, bro. I got to get out of Buffalo.
High stakes cannot get here soon enough.
I'm telling you, man.
Man, I'm so anxious for that season. Let's go. All right, next up is Tone Dog and those Seahawks.
Let's get it.
Versus H-Town and the Rams. Now, both of these teams coming off of losses to two very good users. Tone Dog in a defensive battle versus the Bucks. Lost 10-7. Was a close game. Had a chance to win that ball game. Made a couple mistakes. But the Rams, he took a little beat down from the Bears. But that's to be expected. The Bears are very, very good.
Mm-hmm.
But I just don't think the Rams got enough power on their offense to beat that defense in Seattle. I'm picking Tone Dog and the Seahawks with the win.
I don't know what's going on in St. Louis or L.A. Damn, man. Homie had it tough. I'm not really sure what happened in Seattle this year, too, man. Going into the season, you know what we need to do? Total Access, off-season, bro. We need going into the new season... We need to have like a preseason top, playoff team pick, teams that make the playoffs and possible Super Bowl teams too, man. Cause I had Tone making some noises going into the season. I had him making some noise this year.
Man, I had the Rams making noise. I had the Rams in the playoffs this year.
I'm not sure what happened, man.
Yeah.
I feel like him giving up those picks, though. I had a love-hate thing with the trade he made for that wide receiver Coleman. I'm never a fan of giving up three picks for one player. I'm never a fan of that. Never. And he did it. But, I mean, it's a quality wide receiver, but still. Where you're obviously, I mean, you're lacking some depth this year, and you could have used that with those three picks, especially that first. Oh, my God. So, Cleveland, once again, making out like a thief with more picks, man. Going to another season with more picks and a possible top five pick.
It's crazy.
Possible top five pick, man.
Crazy. Get richer, man.
Yeah. Man. Here we go again. Man. God damn.
And Hot Tub said, just got another pick.
Yeah. Jeez, oh, my God. Do better, guys. You got to participate. Just participate, man. I'm tired of seeing three picks just go like that.
No doubt.
Man, I'm tired of seeing that, man. That's what we need active users in here. I'm not going to harp on it anymore, though. Kick these motherfuckers out. Starting with skill trades. Let's start getting them out of here. I'm serious. Kick them out. But with that being said, man, Tone Dog with the win this week.
Tone Dog with a win. Well, we got one more game. We won't waste a lot of time. No. It's El Guapo and the 49ers going up against the Houston Texans. El Guapo reminded me last week why I should stop picking him to win football games.
I told you that forever ago, bro.
So I'm picking the Texans. Texans with a win.
Shout out my man Carl, man, down there in Houston, man. Jumping on love, hate, man. Big shout out to you, bro.
Had a good time
enjoying you on the show. Houston with the win, man. He had a bit of a tough year. I feel like he's going to get some stuff straight in the offseason and make something happen on that division, man. He's got a tough division with Andy Force and them Jags and A-Speed and them Titans. That's a tough division, so he's definitely scrapping for that third spot. So hopefully he makes some adjustments and bring in some guys, some key guys to stay afloat in that division. But he's going to get the win this week, man, and keep the ship going into the offseason, man. Houston with the win.
All right. Houston with a win. One more thing of business. Deion put a little post out today talking about football being a game of adjustments. Mm-hmm. Asking that each user just mix it up on offense and defense.
Mm-hmm.
Guys, I don't know if y'all take it seriously, but he is so right. Playing a game, an hour-long game, having to see the same stuff over and over and over again.
Cheesy.
Man, it gets old, man. It gets boring.
Extra cheesy.
And I hate to say this, but we got some users in here that just haven't listened to the words of the commish saying, mix it up. There's 500 plus plays in Madden. You can't tell me you can't run 40 of those, 50 of those a game. Now, don't get me wrong, and there is not a user in this league that's going to tell you we don't all have our money plays.
Oh, yeah.
We all do, no doubt. But we try to sprinkle those in periodically. We're not trying to run them back-to-back. And just because you change one receiver's route on the play, that's not running a different play. That's just making one adjustment.
Mm-hmm.
If you look up and you've thrown 8 drag routes in a row, something is wrong.
Mm-hmm.
If you're checking it down to the running back 12 times in a game, something is wrong. You need to get it fixed. With that being said, if you have an opponent doing that, I'm going to continue running the same defense to stop your cheese, because that's just how it has to be. So don't gripe and complain when you see the same coverage because you run in a streak every single play.
But it's sad to even take it there, because at that point, the game's not even fun. Like, my interest in the game is done. And there's always that possibility, you know, as sometimes I can't even, you know, I may not be able to stop it,
because
you know, you're causing cheese. So maybe we need to actually bring a rule, because the fact that we don't have a rule and we've got guys testing that, pushing that to the limit, maybe we need to get a rule in here about the ratio, because that's my main thing. It's the ratio that I have an issue with.
Right.
Because I play many of guys that will run, that will pass the ball by third quarter, they probably ran 16, 17, 18 pass plays and only run maybe 2 to 3 running plays.
Yeah.
Like that's what I have an issue with. So it's more of a ratio thing with me, man. Mix up your ratio. If you guys seen me play before, my shit is balanced out throughout the entire game. That's why I have a dogfight with a lot of you guys. Because a lot of you guys that run the same old thing, you know, either run a lot or pass a lot, I'm gonna be there with you coming into the game. I play a very balanced football game. So just, you know, mix up the ratios, man. Maybe we need to get a rule in there to mix up your ratios. Because Hamilton called out the homie Houdini the other day about his ratios.
Yeah.
That man passes the ball, what, 55% of the game? He 55% of the time and runs the ball a whopping 17% or something like that. That's pathetic, man.
The crazy part was he had like 50% streak routes.
Yeah.
Like, come on, man. Like, that's...
That's not Simba, bro.
It's not Simba. And it's not accepted in the Dynasty. And I know that the ratio rule is on the table for the next season. So, big shout out to the commissions. Always trying to improve the Dynasty.
Oh, yeah. Definitely gotta
touch
that.
We hate adding rules in every single week, but we gotta do stuff to make this the most sim league possible.
Yep.
Because guys, we're not shooting to just be another franchise dynasty type of league. We shooting to be the best sim league that PlayStation has ever seen. We have much higher heights. I love that Matty Ice posted that picture of that guy trying to get into the league. The dude was like, y'all got your own network? Like that. See, but he doesn't even realize how deep it is. We got our own network, but we also got, everyone got their own Twitter account. We Twitch all of our games. We have multiple shows on the account. People just don't realize how much we got going on. And it's only a matter of time before this explodes. We get the right person to see our league and promote us, and it's gonna be quick. And some of y'all are going to be left behind, and you're gonna be that dude on Madden that says, "I used to be in the dynasty."
Shoulda, coulda, woulda, ass motherfucker, man. That's what they're gonna be.
And then you're gonna be sitting there saying, "Man, I wish I could get back in, but it'll be too late at that point."
I'm gonna shout y'all out too. I'm gonna shout out all the Jets that was in the league too. I'm gonna shout
Total Access. We're not pulling no punches no more. If we think you should get the boot, we gonna let you know on the show. Need to get the boot. We done playing. Some of y'all users, time for y'all to go, because we got people begging to get into this league. Begging. They can't wait. So, enough of the soapbox for me and Farquaad, but you know we gotta speak our minds, because that's who we are. But those are our picks for week 14.
Just
our opinion. Prove us right, prove us wrong. It's your boy Expert, and you know I got Farquaad with me.
Let's get it.
We out.